Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us thereafter. And before I move to the next point, we need to realize that I was saying when you are marrying, look for the father of your children. Think to yourself, is this person fit to be the mother of my children or the father of my children, depending on whether it is the man or the woman who is looking into this. And if they are not fit for that, then opt for someone else. No matter how blossoming it sounds and how beautifying it sounds. As I say, you see the lamps that we have here. The light, the bulb that you have, one day it will pop. The light that you have, one day it will pop, subhanallah. So if you marry someone for the bright look on their faces, one day that bright look will pop, it will go. When the creases start coming below the eyes, then people begin to turn for others. May Allah protect us. But if you married them for the heart, for what you love inside, that will only increase and develop as the years go further. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that it is important that when a woman wants to marry, you don't block her for no reason. If you are the father of a female, you don't block her for no reason. A woman wants to marry. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about those who are married, when they are having a problem and they are separated, then they want to get back to their husband. Sometimes you get family members who come to them and say, no, don't. If they want to get back and if they want to marry them or remarry them in the case where it is allowed, then in that particular case, if you block them, then you will be a major sinner. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't block the females from marrying whom they would like to marry, unless obviously there is an Islamic reason for you to block it, like the man is a drunkard or he is a drug addict or he is extremely oppressive and so on. But if there is no Islamic reason, just because you don't get on with them, does not mean your daughter must not marry them. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection and understanding. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, فَلَا تَعْضُلُوهُنَّ أَن يَنْكِحْنَ أَزْوَاجَهُنَّ إِذَا تَرَاضَوْا بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. In the instance of a woman who is separated or divorced, and after that she wants to get back to the same individual, if three divorces are not issued, only one was issued or two, and she still wants to get back to that man, then you should allow her to get back if she wants. Don't block her and don't stop her, on condition that the two have arrived at an understanding of goodness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us from that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us about the engagement. Let me clarify this for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the word khitbah, which means the engagement. In Islam, an engagement is only a confirmation that the two of us are going to get married. That is already an engagement. There is no party, there is no distribution of sweets, there is no nothing. All that is excess, it is culture, and it is something that sometimes we make life difficult through. The mere fact that two families have agreed that we are going to get married inshallah, or the two are going to get married, you are already engaged, subhanallah. There is nothing like an engagement ring in Islam. All that is extra, it's excess. And people who do it, if they do it just out of happiness, inshallah, it should be okay. But if they do it thinking that it's a must, hey, we're engaged, where's my ring? Otherwise I'm going to break this engagement. If that's the case, you don't need to marry that woman. Believe me, because when you marry, she will ask you for your pay packet the day you get your salary. Allahu Akbar. And one day when your salary is less, she might even instruct you to move out of the house. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. The hadith speaks about marriage and says, "Inna min a'zami an-nikahi barakatan aysaruha ma'una." Some of the marriages that are the most blessed are those that the least amount of wealth is used, least extravagance. You know, when we have marriages, we are taught to have a simple marriage. Why? Because it is an act of worship. Marriages are acts of worship, and this is why when we have our functions of walima, a walima is the function out of happiness. It is an act of worship that we have either at the hall or at the home. We must make sure that we do not engage in earning the anger of Allah. Marriage is half of your iman, according to one of the narrations. The walima or that party is a celebration of half of your iman. If you are celebrating half of your iman by allowing women to come into the gathering who are not even dressed properly, or the bride herself is half naked and the groom wants to sit with the females, then you are celebrating half of your iman by pleasing shaitan. Your marriage won't work. It will not work, I guarantee that. Also, if you have had, for example, a function where there is a mixed gathering of male and female mixing and dining and whining and everything haram happening, in that case we are celebrating half of our iman. Let's think how we have just did that. We need to engage in tawbah, some of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our shortcomings. Some who are already married have already done that. Now do you know why you had problems in your marriage? May Allah protect us. Because the seed, when it was sown, you watered it with urine. May Allah protect us. And that is a very strict statement. It's very harsh, but it's a reality. Believe me, it makes us boil when we think of how people will please shaitan. May Allah not make us from that. And they won't listen to any of the ulama. They won't understand. Shaitan wants to contaminate you from the very celebration of half of your iman. That is why you'd rather not have the function if you would like to have it in a manner that will please shaitan. Feed two people at your house, that is enough. Feed the poor in an orphanage, that is enough. But if you would like to have gatherings where everyone besides Allah is going to be happy, only shaitan will be worshipped, then that is not the way to celebrate half of your iman. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open the doors for us. Marriage is one of the most important things everybody looks towards and looks forward to from a very early age. And this is why it is a reality. We need to discuss it and we need to spend our time in this regard. I think every single one of us, if ever we are getting married or we know of someone getting married or one of our children is getting married, let us instruct them and let us try and teach them to have that function or that party totally separated gathering within the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like we are in the masjid, we are totally separated. That is also an act of worship which is celebrating half of your iman. We lose it and we think it's a party. Immediately after the party, they go on honeymoon, they come back separated. May Allah protect us all. It is increasing because most people, even the most religious of people, when it comes to their functions, sometimes what they do, they compromise what is right and wrong. And if that is the case, how are we going to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We want children, we want offspring. The seed we sowed from day one was already wrong. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never do that to us. This is why the nikah, the sunnah, is to have it in the masjid, in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it is the most blessed of places. It is not the house of the president, nor the most expensive house around. MashaAllah, on the day of happiness, yes, we are allowed to be happy. We wear new clothes and we wear this and we wear that. For the brides, the message is never ever wear something that will reveal your body the day you are going for that function, because that body is a gift for your husband and not for the rest of humanity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Then the next day when you attend another function and there is another bride whom your husband sees with even a better body because it is revealed, don't blame anyone besides yourself when he turns in that direction. May Allah protect us. So these are statements that require digestion. They are solid, they are serious, and they are common sense. Really, they are instructions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Marriage is a gift. It is a holy union. It is a noble coming together of two individuals to increase the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We need to treat it like an act of worship, I think, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help our eyes open and may He forgive our shortcomings. Remember, if you've erred in the past already, I see the gloomy faces once again looking at me. May Allah protect us all. We need to engage in tawbah and istighfar. Allah is most forgiving. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forgiving, most merciful. But we will not promote vice. And we will never ever swallow words of justice when we have to utter them just to please people. Another thing I'd like to bear in mind, and I'd like everybody to bear it in mind, is that it is prohibited for us to attend a function where haram is going to happen, even if it is the nikah of your own father or brother or son or sister or uncle or aunt. You will not attend in order not to be from amongst those who have made shaitan happy when someone is supposed to be celebrating half of their iman. And it is about time the ulama of this ummah decide to abstain and boycott all those functions of walima where there is a mixed gathering. Let us not attend where there is a small cubicle in the corner only for ulama. Are the ulama the only males of the ummah just because they have beards and the rest of them are females? May Allah protect us all. No. That is an insult. To have a cubicle in a corner is like a commentary box when we are commentating for cricket. Really. Then they want us to give commentary from there in a corner to say, please give a lecture. Wallahi, it's better we don't attend. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Because that is a celebration of half of Iman. How can the ulama bless a celebration of half of Iman being watered down by shaitan's water? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. We have every reason to cry. Wallahi, the ummah is degenerating into chaos. Because our children are so unruly. Because the day we got married, we never thought of the fact that we are marrying for children. We just got happy and trigger happy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding.